books. No, these words have come from the bottom of our heart and work experience, whatever is cluttered in our brain. So in one way I can say, whatever you are going to listen now, that will state way will be coming out of horse's mouth. You know that one? Horse's mouth? Because if you want to know about the race or to run in the race, you have to learn from the horses. So we will start this one session. As I already told you, I am Anand Kumar Asuja and I am marketing head of Rural India Solar Energy Rise Enterprise. One more introduction left, that I am father of Vipin Anand Asuja. We are son-father duo running this EPC firm. And yeah, I forgot to tell that they are also father-son duo who are looking after growing technology. Be talking more, and this training session of mine will be very crisp and summarized one. You all are graduate, you know that on one word we can speak hours together. We are not going to speak like that. One word, it should be sufficient for you to understand what we are conveying. And one more thing, we are not here to teach you anything. Okay? We are here to interact with you. If it goes beyond you, there is no use of this training session. So, we will speak at your level, not at instructor level. Right, sir? Okay. So, first of all, as we always listen, that don't show your dislike in front of a person. This is the first basic funda of business. Or in an organization where you work, even if you hate your boss, don't show that dislike on your face. I had got a boss who used to abuse in talk.
I would like to request all of you to just keep writing and listen.
Okay. So I had got
the first word that we have learned is don't show dislike. Right.
So I had got a boss who used to abuse in his talk while speaking to me or while speaking to the other subordinates. I had made a funda in my life when he is talking nonsense. I will not even give him a smile. I will stand just like a subordinate, or I will sit in the chair just like a subordinate, but I will not give a smile. That means I am not saying that yes, if you are abusing, it is good. No, it is not good, but you cannot show your annoyance on your face because he is your boss. So be neutral. Be neutral. Yeah, you may be hating that person, but be neutral. It should not come here. Okay? Then, all elders are to be addressed as sir. Let them be anyone. I remained in a foreign country for 3 years and I found that all the elderly people, irrespective of their caste, creed, breed, or reputation or position, they are to be addressed as sir. If you make this habit, if you inculcate addressing elder people as sir, and if you make it a habit, I am telling you, you will go many ladders up. Simple habits in your life can change your life forever. But it should be habit. And habit in your life should be in such a way that if you brush your teeth every day, it should be a habit. Then only your teeth will remain hygienic. Okay, If you get up at 5 o'clock in the morning every day, that is habit. If you go for a walk for 30 minutes every day, that is a habit. So habit can change the life. Not one day you got up at 5:30 and then after getting up, you again slept. No. Whatever you follow religiously. Religiously means, whatever happens, you are doing that thing. Once, twice, thrice, every time and always. That is what habit. So if you call an elderly person, as sir, that should be your habit. And once it becomes habit, you will not make mistake. Okay. So elderly person means note the age. Note the age. If a gentleman younger than you is placed above you, he is elderly. I have found bosses who were pilots. Okay, just one glimpse. I am from Indian Air Force background. Okay. So a pilot of 23 years age, who is my boss? He is my boss. I will always salute him and I will always address him as sir. That is different issue, that he is a gentleman like you, he is in return addressing me as sir. So that is his greatness. Because he is respecting my age, my knowledge, my profession, everything. Good. So, one more thing in life, to become a gentleman, never speak against the ladies folk. Don't pass derogatory comments only to enjoy in your friend circle. I'm not telling in front of ladies, no. Even in your friend circle also. Don't talk low about the ladies. Okay? Because if we talk low about the ladies, it straight away reflect upon our bringing up, rearing up, who has mothered us. Okay? It straight away reflect upon our khandan, clan, family. Okay? So don't talk any derogatory remarks about the ladies in your life. Whether they are your boss, whether they are your subordinate, whether they are traveling with you, whether in whichever circumstances, never talk against ladies. Habit. As I told you, there are so many habits in life. You can form them and it can change your life. One habit for a successful businessman and entrepreneur is reading. What is that? Reading. Write down that. Every day, 4:30 minutes, take out time for reading. And reading does not mean you are reading engineering books. Reading does not mean you are reading solar books. No. You even read a novel also. You read a short story. You read a newspaper. You read an article. You read a blog. You read a poem. Whatever you get. But read it. There will be many benefits of reading. One benefit is that your vocabulary will become strong. Your vocabulary will become strong. And then you will not be finding finding words in the roof. You know, we can't complete the sentence and we look to the roof as if words will come down. No. So, if you continuously read in your life, your vocabulary will become strong. And do you know, just out of the subject, one thing is coming to my mind, do you know what is the vocabulary strength of a normal person? Do you know? No? What do you think Shakespeare had? Vocabulary strength. How many words he may be knowing in his whole life, in his brain? What do you think? Words, I'm talking words. How many?
No idea, sir.
Okay. Only 1400 words. Only 1400 words he had memorized in his lifetime in his brain. And with those 1400 words, he had written the literature of English language. Any novelist, if you are reading a big novel, Orker. What is the name of that that one?
Jeffrey Archer.
So if you are reading that one, do you know what is his vocabulary? 600 words. A professor of a university or PhD, you know what is the vocabulary of, vocabulary strength of his? How many? 300. Only 300 words. And what is the vocabulary strength of mine? You know that one? No. Only 120 words. How many? So if you know the 120 words, you can speak fluently English. Nobody can stop you in speaking in English language so fluently. You only require anywhere between 120 to 150 words for a common person to speak fluently. But how does it come? It comes by reading. Read it. And you know what was my habit? We were talking about habits, sir. You know what was my habit as a child also? That if I get an envelope made of newspaper or magazine, sir, I wrote something from the market, I wrote that envelope, then I will tear it off, make it plain, I will read that content. That was the habit of mine since my childhood. I was so ardent reader wherever I go, and if I happen to find a library, जैसे दिमाग लकड़ी को चट कर जाता ना, मैं ऐसे वो पढ़ जाता। I was a ghost reader also. लेकिन मेरी है, it has been my habit to grasp only that essence from that book, whatever my brain or my soul says that it is required. Otherwise, if you ask me even a single name of a person, I have read so many times Jaffrey Archer, but I was not remembering name. I asked that gentleman. Why? Because it is of no importance to me. Jaffrey Archer word is not important to me. So many times how I practice in my life, that if an information is not of importance, I do not clutter it in my brain. Okay. If you go more and more, I can't stop talking, you know. Okay, use of computers and smartphones in your profession. Never hesitate. Even at the age of 50, I learned computer. At the age of 50, I learned programming. At the age of 50, I learned how to design website. Okay. So, never hesitate to use computer. And computer is not such a thing, if you put your finger in the computer, that will go wrong. No, it has been made by the human being. Okay. Nothing can go wrong in the computer. You can use it in any way. And everything can be corrected. Don't worry about that, yeah. Including smartphone also. Use the latest technology, always. Dressing. For meeting, always full sleeve, collar and tucked in. Always make it a habit. Whether you are engineer, whether you are IAS, whether you are administrator, whether you are manager or whatever you are. If you are going for a meeting, anywhere or attending office, it has to be collar, full sleeve, tucked in. And when you are tucked in and wearing a trouser, not jeans. When you are wearing trouser, then it has to be a leather suit or leather suit. Never wear the sports shoe on your trouser, especially when you are tucked in or you are wearing a blazer. Never wear sports shoe. It is low, degrading. Okay. Sports shoe mean for leisure. Simple. Walking, leisurely. Casual. If you are wearing t-shirt and jeans, wear sports shoe. Yeah. But for meeting, it is always a dress code. Maintain that dress code. If you are attending a function, anywhere, being an engineer or being an entrepreneur, you will get, when you will get the formal invitation, na, there it is written, sir, know that one. Dress code, formal or informal. Remember that one. Formal means, informal means, whatever you like. Okay. There are so many things what we can talk about, but one more habit you should inculcate in yourself, that if you feel that it is the right decision and swiftly you can take decision, go and execute it. That means swift decision, swift execution. Make a habit of yours. If you make this habit in your life, nobody can stop your success. Yes, but people will be there talking against you. But now, never bother what people will say about your decisions and execution of task. If your gut feeling says that, it is right, do it. What will happen? It may be a wrong decision by you. Yes. So, kya hoga? Galti to hoti hai, bhai. Sabse hoti hai. But you are not delayed the things. You are not sitting on that file. Understood? You are not keeping the job pending. You have not kept the file in the left tray, pending. That is a bad habit of officials or whoever is decision maker. Always take swift decision. If you take, you will go many more better. Now, threat, speech and conversation. So, use such language which could be understood by each and everyone, wherever you are standing, sitting, or in the meeting, or wherever you are. Speak that language which could be understood by everyone. So, by the way, we are comfortable in English?
Yes.
Or to repeat with me, smile the nigga. उससे मुझे confidence रहेगा कि yes, I am talking right. Okay. So, Your idea when conveyed should be beyond mistakes. Should be beyond mistake in the recipient mind. If you are telling that pick up this tripod with video camera and put it in the back side, recipient should not have any doubt what I have conveyed. Understood? So your orders, your instruction to the subordinate, to your team should not be ambiguous. Should not be ambiguous. It should be free from any further idea making. Don't leave it generalized that they will guess and then they will act upon as per their own wish and will. No. Because you are the manager. You are the manager. So you have to manage that person. You have to give him that instruction. You have to give that order so that he doesn't have any doubt in his mind about your order and instruction. Okay? So it says your orders and instruction to your team should be so precise and perfect so that there exists no doubt in the recipient mind. Understood? Now, approach towards ladies and elderly people. This is such a habit, if you follow, you will form a personality of yours as a gentleman in the society wherever you go. Whether you are in a wedding reception, whether you are in a office meeting, whether you are in a market, whether you are in mall, whether you are in your friend circle, wherever, it will apply to you. So what it says? Do not address friends, wives, or your senior person, wife as Bhabi ji or Auntie ji. Hello. She may be very elderly, but you can't tell your boss wife as Auntie ji or Bhabi ji. Yeah, you may be calling your boss as brother. He may be calling you as brother. Hi, brother. But you can't call her wife as Bhabi ji. Got it, na? Or if she is more elderly figure, then you can't call her Auntie ji. No. And what do you say? Yeah. Your behavior towards a lady should be so appropriate that your mother or sister should not feel bad about you. Bas, one sentence mein, baki saare jo bhi likhi hai bakwas hai. Your behavior with the lady should be so appropriate that your mother or sister should not even feel bad about it. Simple life and other life dynamic. Because they are the people in our life who has reared up our mother and sisters. So if they are the figure of disrespect, you can disrespect the whole society ladies. But if they are respectable figures, you have to respect all the ladies. Yes, you can love a lady differently than your mother and sister. But you cannot sleep with all the ladies of the world. Understood? Don't see those ladies with that kind of perception in your mind. There is one lady made for you in the whole world on this earth with whom you will be noted. Okay? Speak directly while looking into the eyes so that they could build trust and confidence in you. अगर जो आप लेडीज से बात करते समय आंखें चुराते हैं, she cannot have trust and confidence in you. She may be your colleague also, okay, or your boss also, or your own भाभी जी also. भाभी जी means आपके brother की wife. If you steal the glances, sorry, you are damaging your personality. Speak directly because you don't have wrong thing here about her. And then only you can speak to her directly in her eyes. Otherwise you can't speak. Got it? And gentlemen, do not remain seated in the presence of ladies who are studying. Whether it is bus, tram, train, anything. Accept your seat in the aeroplane. Okay, because that is not for you. You have paid for it and seat also paid for it. So don't get up for the aeroplane, okay? Have a head, sir. When walking with a lady, a man should walk on the curb side. If your boss wife is walking and you are also walking along with her, you have to walk curb side. Curb side means footpath side. Okay? Understood? Because she is the boss now. So you have to be in left side. But if you are walking with your wife, you have to be to her right side. Okay? Protective. Ladies should never be kept waiting for appointments. Finish your all appointments for other ladies. Don't make them wait. Gentlemen should offer his seat to adult women and elderly men in public places. People will laugh on you. When you will get up from the chair, na? Some stupid lady also may be there. She will refuse. No, I don't want to sit. But you should always offer. Ma'am, would you like to have seat? Sir, would you like to have a seat? You are losing nothing in that. If they say no, thank you, keep sitting. But always offer. And some people may laugh from you once you offer a seat to the lady, thinking, okay, bettering kara bhi hai. Let them think. Because it is their own perception. Your perception is what? You are respecting the lady. Simple. Ladies should always be first, irrespective of the occasions. चाहे भंडारा भी चल रहा हो और आपको ये लग रहा हो कि मैं बहुत भूखा हूँ, until unless you are sick for food. हो सकता है मैं एक तरह डायबिटिक और कई दिन से भूख लगा है तो खाना पड़ेगा. Without line also, first of all you are to do. ठीक है. But if you are healthy, okay, then irrespective of the occasion, चाहे वो reception है, शादी का भंडारा है, कुछ भी है, ऑफिस मीटिंग है, ऑफिस का ब्रंच है, लंच है, व्हाटएवर इट इज, लेडीज शुड बी ऑफर्ड फर्स्ट एंड सर्व्ड फर्स्ट. वन मोर थिंग, इन योर लाइफ नेवर ऑफर योर हैंड फॉर शेकिंग हैंड विद द लेडीज. नेवर ऑफर फ्रॉम योर साइड. इफ अ लेडी इज एक्सटेंडिंग हर हैंड, यस यू मस्ट, बट व्हाट शुड बी द वे टू डू दैट वन. कैन यू प्लीज एक्सटेंड योर हैंड. तो मर्द लोग ऐसे ऐसे करते हैं, ठीक है, जब मर्द के साथ में हाथ मिलाते हैं, मिलाओ ऐसे हाथ, ऐसे मिलाते हैं, लेकिन अगर लेडीज ने हाथ मिलाया तो आप ऐसे करो, लेडीज ने ऐसे हाथ मिलाया तो आप ऐसे करो, बस इससे ज्यादा नहीं। शी शुड नॉट फील कि यू हैव ड्रेस फॉर हैंड, लेकिन आप जिंदगी में गार्ड पहन लेना, किसी से भी मिलते हो हमेशा गर्म जोशी से मिलना। अब मैं बताता हूँ आपको कैसे मिलते हैं लोग, सर आप अपना हाथ देना, देखो इनको पता ही नहीं चला कि मैंने इनसे हाथ मिलाया, कैसे मेरे मुस्कान की सब कुछ है, बट व्हाट इज इट, आपको मुझसे मिलकर खुशी नहीं हुई यार, तो हाथ मिलाओ ऐसे, हाय, ये होता गर्म जोशी से, उसको फील होना चाहिए कि यस आपके अंदर पावर है।
When you are learning the things of life जो आप normally नहीं करते होंगे, लेकिन ये जब आने वाले time में इस तरह की चीजें अगर आप follow करेंगे तो आप एक perfect gentleman बनोगे।
सोशल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी, सो वी हैव सोशल रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑन मैनी ओकेजन्स, वन इज सोशल फ्रेंडशिप, इफ यू डोंट हैव फ्रेंड इन योर लाइफ यू आर नॉट सोशल रिस्पॉन्सिबल, इफ यू डोंट हैव योर नेबर्स एज योर फ्रेंड यू आर नॉट ए सोशल पर्सन, ए पर्सन हु इज हैप्पी विद हिज नेबर, नेबर वेरी वेरी फर्स्ट नेबर टू योर लेफ्ट एंड राइट, इफ दे आर हैप्पी विद यू, you think yourself that you are the most respected and revered figure in the earth, on the earth. Agar jo aapke padosi aapse khush hai, okay, so calls of inquiries are made during illness, koi bhi vyakti aapka acquaintance jaan pehchan wala, if anyone is sick, your relative, your friend, your acquaintance, your colleague, anyone is sick, you must call either physically or by phone or by any means. You must give a message that, sir, yeah, you will be recovering by the grace of God and by the help of doctors, but we stand by with you. God bless you with happy or sorry, fast recovery or convulsive death. Understood? This one word will make you to get up from the bed, not the medicine. Understood? He will think what? That, अरे यार मेरा friend कितनी दूर से चल के आया, यार मेरा friend वहाँ से आया. So that kind of feeling, it is no, that kind of feeling is healing, healing, feeling is healing. Okay. So once you feel good, you will heal from the inside. Once you feel bad, you will not heal, but you will have wound. You will have wound and injuries inside on your soul. But we are not taken birth on this earth to get the injuries and wound on our soul. Okay, we have come here to nurture our soul. Nurture, uska palan karna, poshan karna, uska happy rakhna, uska khush rakhna. Okay, so pass on condolence should be your test if there is a death anywhere, and if you go here for condolence proper, it should be shorter, within 5 to 10 minutes, just leave that space, because many people are to come and you have to leave room for them. Sometimes people by sitting there, they think, should I get up or not? No, you must get up. Many people, they don't have idea, 1 or 2 hours they will be keep on sitting there, but it is not required. In the shortest time, get up from there, leave that place. Okay. Invitations are either formal or informal and must be either answered or attended. If you don't attend, then you have to write a sorry letter or you have to convey sorry. Thank you very much for your invitation I received, but due to this problem, I convey my inconvenience to reach or to attend that function. Or if you have forgotten that one, after the function you should send that kind of message to the person who has called you. That shows that you care. Otherwise, next time, you will not call him. Ethics. Now, what is ethics? We both of us listen ethics in our life. Yeah, follow the ethics.
But what is ethics?
Ethics is one word. Ethics, E-P-H-I-C-S. But what is ethics? We never come to know what is ethics. So this is more important, right ethics. Ethics is the science of morals. Moral principles. And rules of conduct. How do you conduct yourself? That is ethics. What principle you follow in your life, that is ethics. What morals value you have, that is ethics. Concept of doing one's duty, is central to ethics. Is central to ethics. That means, if I am doing my own duty, whatever that duty is, even the sweeping also. So that is my ethics. Okay. I would like to tell you that I was in Bangkok, Son Bhumi Airport. I got down and I went for visit. Went for washroom. Then there were ladies cleaning the area. So normally we Indian people, we hesitate about pissing in front of the lady. Though we urinate and defecate outside. But especially if ladies are seen, we can't imagine of this. So that was my first landing in Bangkok. So I hesitated by entering in the washroom and I waited that that lady clean. Then once she is out from the men's toilet, then only I will use. But she told, no sir, please. Because she has seen many Indians like that. No sir, you please carry on your business because I am carrying on my business. You keep on doing your business, I am doing my business. Don't stop yourself, please. So that was my first instance. Then what I found, duty, we are talking about duty. So, you know, how she used to do duty? She is beautiful like any Indian Bollywood filmy actress. Okay, but she is sweeping the toilet, cleaning the toilet. But that doesn't mean she will degrade herself. You know what she will do? I have observed her very, not her, I mean all the ladies working there, over there. What they will do? Every after half an hour, they will take out one mirror from their vanity bag and they will pop up, they will make their lipstick okay and do like that and they are okay. They will keep it back. Again, she will go and start cleaning. Or we are the gloves or urinal port ko aise saaf karti hai saaf aapne ke saath kiya duty. Okay, same lady which is beautiful than any Indian filmy actress, but it is her duty. So what we are telling, concept of doing one duty is central to ethics. I hope I made my point clear about ethics. So that is ethics. Rest of the things are secondary, but what is ethics? Duty. Duty is central to ethics. Now, second thing comes values. Write down values. Values are principle and judgment of what is right, wrong, important to a person. What is right, wrong, truth, lie, or judgment, making judgment, that is value. But how do you value that one? Loyalty. What is your loyalty towards your organization? Or to your job? Or to your family? That is value. Respect. How do you respect ladies? How do you respect elderly people? How do you respect your parents? That is value. Excellence. Excellence in your work. in your performance, in whatever you do, you achieve excellence. That is attitude. Your attitude towards anything. What is that attitude? That is value. It may be good or bad or negative or positive, but it is value. Accountability. Do you own accountability? Being a manager of whatever has gone wrong, do you own the accountability? If you own the accountability, that is value. But if you disown, that is a negative value. Suppose you are telling, your team is going to, they are too stupid because they have made wrong things. So you are disowning your responsibility or accountability. So that is negative value, but it is a value. Mission orientation. Mission orientation. If this value you have, mission orientation, you will be succeeding in your business, in your organization. Teamwork. If you are a manager and if you do not know how to work as a team member, you can't get the job from the team. First, you have to learn yourself. Being a team person, then only you can. Professional knowledge. इसको बोलते हैं PK और SK. PK और SK. Professional knowledge और service knowledge. What are you doing? Service. PK और SK. If you are convergent with PK and SK in your organization, you are the master of that organization. You are the boss. Though you may be designated at a lower level, but if you are expert in PK and SK, you are the chairman of the organization, will be knowing you and come to you for the solution. That is my experience of working. Okay. So your PK and SK, you go anywhere in any office, just take out all the manuals, all the rules, regulations of the organization and start reading. Mug them up. Mugging up. Totally. It should be here. Your boss cannot memorize all those rules, regulations, but you should be able to. But mera kaam karne ka tarika kaisa tha, sir? I would like to tell that if my boss is feeling asthmatic, what? Asthmatic. If he is feeling suffocation, then one word should come out from his mouth. Where is Mr. Asodia? Call him. So I used to make my bosses dependent upon me. Dependent upon me. Agar jo life mein, organization mein apni pad bithani hai, lekin isse ek baat hogi ki aap sari umar nokar hi rahoge. Because you only learn what? How to make your boss dependent upon you. So what you are doing? You are working. Yeah, though you have gained the management skills, but you have to go on top. Understood? And your personal character traits. And your personal character traits. What you are. From the inside, from the outside, how do you carry yourself, how do you dress, how do you speak, how do you meet with the people, how do you behave. These are all our personal character rights. These are some of the values what we have just now discussed. Even one value or principle in your life can make difference. I am telling you in long term. Like I told you are getting up at 5:30, 6 o'clock after your daily routine, you are out in the ground and every day you are walking only 15 minutes and coming back. This only one principle in your life will have difference in your life. बट इधर लोंगर टॉप
एक छोटी सी बात मैं बताता हूँ. मेरे पोती है अभी 3 महीने की है. वो कभी भी मतलब नया बंदा मिलता है एक बार स्माइल मार आदत है कि sitting back there, just smile. सुबह से लेकर शाम तक एक ही काम आपने करना है. अगले को जब आप उसके चेहरे पर स्माइल आप देखते हो उसको, उसका किसी भी तरीके से आप गुस्से में हो, वो किसी भी टाइप का हो, आपके साथ में कोई झगड़ा हो रखा हो और आपने स्माइल मार दी, उसका लेवल एकदम नीचे. सो दिस इज एथिक्स, ये भी एक बड़ा एथिक है. ये
दिस इज पर्सनल ट्राइट्स, कैरेक्टर ट्राइट्स.
बिल्कुल, दिस इज आल्सो एथिक्स.
Can we go to the next lesson? Okay, so next is mission. Sab bolte goal, mission. Kya hota wo? What is mission and goal? Okay, so mission is the goal of your career. Mission is the goal of your career, your life, and your profession. Whatever you do. It is not that you are only doing a naukri or job. That is your that may be your career, but profession. ठीक है, मैं जो है ना जूता बनाता हूँ या जूता काटता हूँ, that is my profession. Okay, so mission is the goal of your life. Then what is the goal of life actually? What can anyone explain to me, what is the ultimate goal of life? Anyone? Ultimate goal of life mean, we are taken birth on this earth. What is that goal? Why we are here?
Live happily.
Live happily. Anyone?
Peace of mind. Success. Peace of mind.
Peace of mind.
A good man.
So, actually, ultimate goal, if you talk about Veda or Sanatan, then it is only to nurture our soul. Only to nurture our soul. ये दुखी है तो आप पाप कर लो यार, रिजल्ट सिंपल है जाए. अगर ये सुखी है तो आपका जीना सार्थक है इस जीवन में. ये बिल्कुल टॉपिक से हटके बोल रहा हूँ ये बात. अगर तो ये दुखी है आत्मा, अगर तो आपके दुखी है किसी वजह से, तो और वो वजह आपके आपके हाथ में है उस वजह को ठीक करना. मान लो मैं सच में नाराज हूं, नाराज हो गया इस वजह से, लेकिन यहाँ पे दुख भी है क्योंकि इज माई डियर पर्सन. तो अब मेरा फर्ज क्या बनता है, मैं जाऊं इनकी नाराजगी दूर करूं, बस यहीं पे शांति मिल जाएगी और वो पीस मिलेगी आपके लिए, शांत होगी आत्मा.
सो दिस इज द बिगेस्ट एथिक जो अपनी जिंदगी में सीखना है. सबसे बड़ी बात यह है कि भी हमें मनुष्य जाति में जन्म लिया है और जो हमारे वेदास, हमारे जो शास्त्र हैं, वो यही कहते हैं कि भी आपका एक सिंगल एम ऑफ द लाइफ इज टू नर्चर योर सोल, जैसे उन्होंने बताया, एंड टू मीट दिस सुपर सोल. परमात्मा के पास हमने जाना है, ये हमारी जिंदगी का एम होता है. वैसे जिसको ओनली हम लोग थोड़ा बहुत समझ पाते हैं, पूरे वर्ल्ड में कोई रिलीजन, कोई मतलब कल्चर नहीं करता. और हम इस इंडिया में अभी हम उससे दूर होते जा रहे हैं इस चीज से.
एक बात आवर साइंस,
ठीक है, ये जो बेसिक चीज़ें हम आपको सिखा रहे हैं अभी, अगर इन चीज़ों को अपने अंदर आप इंक्रिकेट कर सकते हैं, अंदर में वो कर सकते हैं, यू आर नॉट ओनली गुड बिजनेस मैन, यू विल बी ए गुड ह्यूमन बीइंग.
ओके सर, सो नाउ द क्वेश्चन कम्स, How do we achieve that goal or mission? Vipin? how do we achieve that goal and mission? Okay. It is very simple to understand, but very, very, very difficult to implement. Your battery is running low. Okay, sir, we will take a 10-minute break for refreshment because I जब बोलता हूँ तो ज़्यादा बोलता हूँ तो अगले वाला bore हो जाता है just और fatigue हो जाता है so let us refresh ourselves. Meanwhile we will refresh this one also.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes, please.